Will Snyderwine will kick it away. Jones and Richardson are the deep backs. And it's headed in the direction of Julio Jones inside the five. Out across the 20. Has some blocks. Scoops across the 40-yard line. Good field position for Alabama to start out with 37 yards on the return.
This Alabama offense is one of the most multiple offenses I've ever seen. Every series they come out in a different look.
Ingram will get the first touch, gets around the edge and breaks into the secondary across midfield, still on his feet down the sideline, and finally bumped out inside the 15. And the first touch of the year is a beauty for Ingram. Hanks and Jones both to the right side. McElroy to the air, into the end zone, and caught for the touchdown. Darius Hanks, the junior from Norcross, Georgia, with his first tally of the season, 9 yards on the strike from McElroy. Brian Morgan, the senior from Hoover, Alabama, will be looking across the line at Josh Chapman, his former high school teammate. The nose tackle for Alabama. Renfrew again to the air, and this time Scott unable to hang on. He heard some footsteps from Mark Barron coming up from his safety spot. Trent Richardson now offset in the backfield. And the quick out to Julio Jones trying to work on the defender, Rubicumba. And he's got first down yardage. Walt Canney knocks him out of bounds after a pickup of 12. Second down after losing the yard. Another quick hitter to Jones, able to shake one defender. Stays on his feet. Jones still going down the sideline, and did he step out of bounds? They're pointing back to the side judge, and now the arms go up. Touchdown, Julio Jones, 51 yards.
After review, replay shows the receiver stepped out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
Dial and Mays to the right. Richardson will run to the left. Gang tackled behind the line of scrimmage. Chris Hazleton, Damian Thornton. Second and 12. McElroy play action looking for Jones deep across the middle. And he catches it for the touchdown. 18 yards on the strike. McElroy to Jones. His third catch of the afternoon. He's had a terrific running game. With a couple of youngsters and a big loss. Marcel Darius, welcome back to the Crimson Tide defense as he throws down Donovan Varner.
And Renfrew has not thrown the ball yet down the field. I'm surprised by that.
Jones is back to receive at the 30. He'll have an opportunity. Spins away from the defender. He's got a wall of blockers in front of him. Jones across midfield. Still on his feet to the 30, but a flag down.
Jones had a picket fence set up for him along that right sideline.
Block in the back, 21 to the receiving team.
Ingram will get the carry. Huge hole to the left side, and Ingram on his way down the sideline. Caught and hauled down at the 26. Matt Daniels saves the touchdown for Duke. Mark Ingram in his season debut, already over 100 yards here in the first quarter. McElroy drops it out to Trent Richardson. A couple of stutter steps would get him inside the 20. Marquise Mays now lining up in the gun. Actually, it's Richardson taking the direct snap. Down to the 14-yard line.
Wildcat.
Puts up 9 yards to get the first down. McElroy back in there. He'll give to Richardson. He is stuffed for a loss. Back out at the 18-yard line. Ingram offset with McElroy, second and 13. To the air, Mays coming underneath. Inside the five, diving for the end zone. And the ball pops out as he makes contact with the ground at the 1 yard line. The give is to Ingram, diving for the goal line and in. Touchdown, Bama.
He's still riding. And I think he's gonna get a flag for a little headbutt at the end of that thing.
Thank you, Robert. Three and done on the first two possessions for Duke. Renfrew with the short fake, and now going deep, and it's intercepted. Dre Kirkpatrick with the catch and back out to midfield with it. Yet another look for the Crimson Tide. And the throw going deep for Hanks. Diving catch inside the 20-yard line. Darius Hanks hauls it in for the big gainer. McElroy 7 of 8 so far for a buck 30. Ingram, nice cutback. Touchdown, Alabama. Ingram from 17 yards out, his second score of the day. Couple of rushing touchdowns, including scampers of 48 and 50 yards, and Josh Sneed on the carry. Their most productive run of the day out across the 35.
Try to get back into a physical type game and wake your guys up, and that's what they're doing right now, running the football to try and get something going in that regard and be physical.
Dante Hightower, the man in the middle this year. And the defensive backs, the most tenured of which is second-year starter Mark Barron. We've already seen Kirkpatrick with an interception and a big burst from Sneed, and the true freshman inside the 35-yard line. Motion man is Varner. Pass across the middle, caught for the first down. Kelly's got it inside the 10-yard line. The pump fake, looking to the corner, and overthrows his man, Austin Kelly. And they cannot convert on that third down there. 22-yard attempt from Snyderwine, who's 4 of 5 on the season. 3 points on the board for Duke.
Except that there's more red, I think, in these stands, Jen, than there is blue. It's pretty liberally sprinkled with crimson. Excuse me, I should say crimson.
They are indeed well represented. We'll delay to Richardson. He scampers out across the 25. Another good pickup on first down.
And this Alabama offensive line.
Tide will show a little hurry up on this possession. It's Richardson again able to elude the first guy that tries to tackle him, and he's got the first down. McElroy goes to the air again. The deep completion to Earl Alexander into Duke territory.
And a pair of TDs. It's been pretty impressive offensive display from Tide.
The bubble to Jones. Squirts around the edge. Got a nice block from Marquise Mays. Play action. McElroy with the pump. Has time to look for a second guy. And the diving interception is made by Lee Butler. Is the setback. Not much happening against Chavis Williams, the senior from Dora, Alabama.
He was a freight train coming straight down the tracks.
Pass of two. Quickly to Scott, cutting back to the inside. And stumbles out close to the 15. Varner, the motion man. And a flag at the snap.
I think Duke moved a little early, I think.
Dead ball, offside, 99 defense.
Thank you very much, Robert. Again on the naked Duke, and the pass caught by Kelly for a short game.
I'm told you can't win the chase in that first race, but you can lose it.
Something to watch for up in Loudoun. The pass to Helfit. And incomplete.
Help it, he dropped that previous pass.
Marquise Mays standing at his own 26. Mays catches it on the run, sheds one tackler.
He's running through a Mays.
Marquise out to the 44. One of the great sports writers of all time. And the team coached, by the way, Eddie Cameron, Cameron Indoor Stadium fame. Greg McElroy, for the first time in a long time, trying to bounce back from an interception. The give to Mark Ingram, who scoots inside the 40 to the 36.
Dorsett back then, wasn't he?
I think you're right, as a freshman, and then he spoke up. The burst from Ingram, still on his feet. Tripped up at the 15.
It's amazing to me how people just bounce off of Mark Ingram.
He's in the pistol now behind McElroy. Greg to the air again, looking for Dial, wide open this time, touchdown, Preston Dial. His second of the season, this one from 15 yards out.
Give him another chance, right? He dropped the previous one.
Winfrey and the offense back out there. To give this to Desmond Scott, also a local out of Hillside High School in Durham. Scooch out close to midfield.
Edmund.
Did a terrific job of replacing Wallace Wade, who was serving with the U.S. during World War II. And a nice snag made by Varner. That'll move the chains. 18 yards on the pickup. Third down for Duke. Renfrey. Not going to get enough on the pass play. Snyderwine is on to attempt it from 42 yards out. Wills Long this year, a 46-yarder. And the guy with the best field goal percentage in Duke history is true. I think the most intriguing stat might be the fact that we'd love to tell you about Alabama's third down conversions, but we can't. They haven't had a third down yet today. The offense has been that efficient. The bobble from Richardson. And still able to make a play. Richardson on his feet across the 40-yard line. Trent Richardson on the go, and he is gone. Touchdown, Alabama.
They're great, and it's an honor to have Alabama here. And our guys will learn from it. That, you know, Coach Cutcliffe's done a great job, and this will help brand our football program. We can be a good football program here.
As we see, Marcel Darius is back out there defensively after sustaining an injury earlier in this second quarter. Renfrey on third and long, gets away from Barron, and has a wide open Austin Kelly diving for the first down marker, and it looks like he got just enough to move him. Denver gives to Sneed. He gets a burst into the secondary. Inside the 30 to the 27-yard line. Eight more from Sneed. He's going to keep it and run straight up the middle and bearing his way inside the 25 on a nice push from the O-line. Third and three. Renfrey. Incomplete. Another drop. And what would have been enough for first down yardage, Hightower plants Varner on his back. From the 16-yard line of the Crimson Tide, a defense that has yet to give up a touchdown this year. Renfrey, caught. And a first down for the Blue Devils. Cooper Helfit hauls it in. Renfrey fires, caught inside the five. And muscling into the end zone is Austin Kelly for the Duke touchdown. The first given up by the Alabama defense this season.
And he's made an impact in that regard.
Trent Richardson returned the last kick 96 yards, and he will not get the opportunity on this one. The ball is loose at the Alabama 37-yard line.
He's going to get kick-catch interference again.
Three receivers from McCarron out of the gun. Across the middle and caught by Dial inside the 30. Foster's two for three. This would be his season long from 44 yards away.
Pretty buff for a kicker.
And he's got the leg and the accuracy. Three more on the board for Alabama.
He hooked that thing. Got it in, though.
Scott will stay in there behind Renfrey. Quick toss to Donovan Varner, swallowed up by Dre Kirkpatrick. A booming blast over Mays' head and taking a nice Duke bounce. All the way down to the 16-yard line. 63 yards on the punt from Alex King. Injured the knee in practice August 30th. Had surgery on it August 31st. Missed out on the first two games for Alabama. making his season debut and a good one today. Julio Jones wide open. Lots of yards after the catch out to midfield for Alabama and a first down. The deep ball down the middle, hauled in at the 20-yard line by Chris Underwood. His first catch of the day, and it's a good one over the shoulder. Second and 10. McElroy to the air again. Tipped by Williams. Got a hand on it, but there's a flag down inside the 5-yard line. The intended receiver was Darius Hanks.
Holding. Defense number 2.
First and goal tied from the 9. The pitch to Ingram. Taken down. Good tackle on the play. Cade Foster. Hit a 44-yarder as time expired at the end of the first half. 21 yards on this attempt. Tough angle, but he gets it through.
And if you know a defense and you understand concepts, that makes everything else easier, you know, rather than memorize.
Oh, took a big pop from Mark Barron on the release. Incomplete. His last punt over 60 yards. Mays giving him a little more respect. He's inside his own 40. He'll get a running start to midfield. Couple of juke moves. Close to the 45. Julio Jones over 100 yards receiving today as Greg McElroy has tied his career high with 3 touchdowns. And here goes Trent Richardson. Trent Richardson with the burst into the end zone. Touchdown tied. 45 yards on the score. A credit, I think, to David Cutcliffe and the administration that they kept the game here despite offers to take it elsewhere. They are trying to build their own tradition here, and they thought that it was very important to their growth as a program. Growing up, he said the hardest thing for him to figure out was how he was going to play for the New York Yankees and be the quarterback at Alabama when he grew up.
Right, he wanted to be the shortstop for the Yankees.
I did notice yesterday when we talked to him, though, the championship ring on his finger was from his days at Tennessee back in 98 with T. Martin. His quarterback pupil. Out of the backfield, Desmond Scott. He's into Alabama territory and has a first down to the 45. 3rd and 3 now for Duke.
Barnett come in at quarterback and down.
Hollingsworth got close to the line. Crimson Tide would love to be Arizona bound for the national championship, but some business to tend to right here on 4th and 1 for Duke. The pitch, Varner, taken down behind the first down marker. They were the best scoring defense in the country last year at just 3 points a game allowed. McCarron on the move and not for long. Sacked on the play by Kelby Brown. And here is the fake. And it's dropped at the 48-yard line.
Alabama center William Vallejos will not be returning to the game with a lower leg injury. They did say, though, that he is fine and could return if they needed him to. Though when we spoke with offensive coordinator Jim McElwain earlier this week, he said that, you know, Vallejos is one of the most important people on this Alabama offense.
You definitely want him as the first one out there on the line.
Call them a commanding presence. In his 17th consecutive start, and Eddie Lacy into the open field, pushed out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. The redshirt freshman. Lacy, going to get another opportunity. Lost the football. Down on the turf, inside the 5.
Lacy fumbled the ball down in this same area of the field. Week 1 against San Jose State, lost the ball.
He is the 3rd Heisman winner that Duke has faced. And 3rd down, and they will come up a yard short. They also played against Doc Blanchard in 46 and then Roger Staubach in 64. Now his career high with 3 touchdown passes today. McCarron unloads it underneath to Brandon Gibson. Cut down inside the 20-yard line. And Duke defensive back Johnny Williams, the St. Stephens, Alabama native, hurt on the play. early in this fourth quarter. The rush coming. Picked up Eddie Lacy down the far sideline, and the redshirt freshman run out of bounds. They call Lacy's number, and he knifes his way through the left side for the touchdown. Eddie Lacy was hit with his third TD of the year. Brandon Clement is now in at quarterback for Duke. Another run down the far sideline. Second and 10 now for Duke after the penalty, and Clement looking to throw his first pass attempt, and it's a completion to Tony Foster. Caught at the 42-yard line. The tackle from B.J. Scott.
And that's something that Coach Cutcliffe is not going to tolerate.
Clement all down. Alex Watkins, the junior linebacker, on the stop.
They'll look at this tape and they'll find something wrong, but they have to be pleased with the effort.
Well, I think he's going to like the fact that they have made what he was looking for, explosive plays, and there have been quite a few of them. In fact, 12 plays today of over 20 yards for Alabama. He had the game-winning touchdown pass today with just 15 ticks on the clock. Running between the hedges, I think that was his first road SEC win in his career.
He was undefeated. Yeah. As a high school quarterback, I believe it's up to, what, 33-0 now. I don't know how to lose. It's going to come as a shock to his system if he ever does, I'll tell you that.
Last loss, I think he was 13 years old in the eighth grade.
Probably remembers it very well.
Fowler short of the first down on third down. We'll get ready to take on Arkansas next week. Duke will have Army. And the final play of the game this afternoon at Wallace Wade Stadium. Nick Saban and the Crimson Tide victorious in their first road trip of the year, and they extend their FBS longest win streak in the country to 17 in a row. The SEC record is Bama's set back in 93 with 28 straight. Our final score, Alabama 62, Duke 13.